Okay, the last method of calculation for estimating the uncollectible, the expected uncollectible amounts to be able to record an adjusting journal entry at the end of the year for bad debt expense. It's called the aging method, aging of receivable method. And the difference between this one and the aging of the percentage of receivable is we're going to be more specific with this method of calculation. And what I mean is we're going to look back at the amounts owed by customers to us, and then we're going to break it down based on the age of that amount owed by the customer. So let's say we have $5,000 owed by a group of customers since between 0 to 30 days. And then there's another amount that is also owed by the customers. It's also part of the balance of accounts receivable. And let's say that was $3,000 owed by the customers between 31 days and 60 days. And then another group of customers for a different amount, $2,000, let's say, a total for that group. And it's been owed by those customers since, let's say, 61 days and 90 days. And then another group, 90 days and over. And when we can make as many groups as we want, depends on the company, how specific they want to be or how much as accurate as possible they want to be. Okay, so you can see now in the table, it shows us the amounts owed by the customers. It's for example, between one day to 30 days, we have let's say $800 owed by Braxton, and then there's another company that owes us $2,100 between 1 to 30 days also, and then there's 13 and 45. So the total of these amounts owed by customers that is between 1 day and 30 days, it's 4,245. And then a different group, if you look at the second column, 31 to 60 days, there's $830 owed. And then 61 to 90 days, there's $1,200. And then over 90 days, there's $100 owed by customers. Now, the idea here is the older that amount owed by the customers, the higher percentage of expected uncollectible amount will be given to that amount because it's been there for a while. And we're not, so that's the difference between this and the previous method. It's not just one percentage. Every group has a different percentage, and then we're just going to multiply these percentages by the amounts and then add them together to find out the total of the ending balance for AFDA, which is the total balance of expected uncollectible amount at the end of the year. Okay, so we, for an example, we just give 1% for the group of amounts owed between 1 day and 30 days. So we multiply the 1% by the 4,245, and then the column 2, we give a higher percentage, 2% or maybe 3 or whatever. So 2% multiplied by 830, we get $17, and then group 3, we give a higher 3%, which is 3%, multiplied by 1,200, you get $36. And then over 90 days, we're almost, we started to give up waiting. We started to feel that, okay, it's most probably not going to be paid. So we gave a very high percentage. We gave 90% percentage of expected uncollectible amounts. So 90% multiplied by $100, that would be $90 that we think is not going to be collected. So add all these totals, 90 plus 36 plus 17 plus 42, we get 185. 185, it's the ending balance of AFDA. So let's make a T account here, just like we did in the previous video, for the AFDA. So again, the amount we came up with, 185, that has to be the ending balance at the end. Remember, that's not the amount we should have in the journal entry because we're using the percentage of receivable. It's not percentage of sales. So be careful. It's not going to be directly to the journal. We have to find out what was the beginning balance or the unadjusted balance for AFDA before we came up with the 185. So let's assume that it was, for example, $80. And then if there was no write-off during the period,
which is going to be a debit balance here, then we just have to do 185 minus 80, which is going to be 105. But let's assume that there was an amount that has been written off during the period for $25, for example. So we have to do our math and solve for X just like we did in the previous video. Okay, so that technique is the same as the previous method. It's just when we came up with the 185, it took us longer time to find it because we used more percentages. Okay, so again, we're gonna do 185 minus 80 plus the 25. And if we do a quick math, that will be $130 here. So that will be $130 for X. And then the journal entry,
again, as usual, it's always going to be debit. And using the allowance method, it's debit to the bad debt expense
for the $130,
and then credit to AFDA or your book. I think in the book it's called Allowance for Bad Debts. So $130.
In the next videos, we'll talk about the rest of the topics from Chapter 8.